We give God the glory for this awesome day. A day of joy, a day of power, a day of divine lifting. A day that God has chosen to bless us. Blessed be to his holy name. In the mighty name of Jesus. In a short while, we'll be encouraging ourselves with the word of God. And I titled it Agape Love. Let's say it together. Agape Love.
Agape Love.
Amen. And our Bible text shall be taken from the book of Romans 8, verse 35. Romans 8, verse 35. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? Amen.
Amen.
Brethren, the love we are talking about here this morning is the love of Christ to us, not our own love to him. So I want you to get, I want us to get this right this morning. The love of Christ to us, not our own love to him. And that love is an unconditional love. That love is gracious.
Amen.
That love is sacrificial.
Amen.
John 3:16. That love is an undeserved love.
Amen.
That love is an everlasting love. Jeremiah 1:3. He loved us and he gave his life unto us. His love never changed.
Amen.
That love has given us hope of an eternal life. That love is a unique love. That love is unique in every way. I pray that the love of God will locate us this morning in the mighty name of Jesus
Christ.
Amen. Now coming to our Bible text. Apostle Paul was just talking about his experience. Everything that was listed here, tribulation, distress, persecution, trials, and so on and so forth, he has passed through it. And God kept him.
Amen.
And the secret of Apostle Paul was his faith. He has a very strong faith in Christ. He believed in the power of God. The more he keep on going through trials, the more God keep building his faith stronger and stronger.
Amen.
We have other biblical examples. We have the three Hebrew men. We also have Job. We also have Paul and Silas, just to mention a few of them that have very strong faith in Christ. My brethren, God needs our faith.
Amen.
In order for us to overcome, in order for us to be victorious, in order for us to enjoy his love, in order for us to be committed even to his word. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What are we talking about this morning? No matter what trials, what persecution, no matter what you are going through in life, lack of job, distress, whatever we are going through in life, the love of God is always there for us.
Amen.
God is giving us an assurance this morning that we should weep not.
Amen.
That he will attend to us just as he attended to Apostle Paul in a very unique way. God is telling us this morning that we shall testify.
Amen.
Just the way Apostle Paul testified.
Amen.
To the greatness of God.
Amen.
When we are faced with trials, when we are faced with tribulations, God is always there.
Amen.
He's interceding for us. He's interceding on our behalf. He loves us. That's why he sacrificed his life for us so that we can live. His love has given us joy. His love has given us peace. His love has given us hope. It's the hope of glory. It's our hope for years to come.
Yes, ma'am.
Brethren, when it seems his promises are not forthcoming, let's build our faith more on him.
Amen.
He will surely attend to us.
Amen.
He will surely manifest his power.
Amen.
Then also, we need to know that nothing can separate us from the love of God, this love that we are talking about. And again, in Ephesians 1:4, the word of God says that he has been He has been for us before the foundation of the world. So what are we talking about? God is always there for us.
Amen.
He has been for us before the foundation of the earth. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Then in John 3:16, we all know it's a very familiar passage. He sacrificed his only son for us so that we can live and have life.
Amen.
So there is nothing that God cannot do for us. God is always there, able to attend to us.
Amen.
Whenever we are going through any trials, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
So brethren, as we conclude this morning, God is giving us an assurance that today, nothing can take away his love from us.
Yes.
Just as we read in his word this morning, in Romans 8:35, nothing, be it trials, tribulation, sickness, lack, those things cannot take his love from us.
Amen.
His love is sacrificial. Mm-hmm. His love is awesome. It's an agape love. Even COVID-19 cannot take the love of God from us.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And we also have an assurance in John 16:33 that says, in this world we have tribulation, but we should be of good courage. We should be of good cheer because God has conquered the world.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I pray that God will attend to us in a very unique way.
Amen.
Even as we continue to call upon him.
Amen.
On a daily basis.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let us pray.
Amen.
Our Father, our Lord, our Maker, our Redeemer, our Fortress, our all in all, Father, we are grateful unto you.
Thank you
for everything that you have done for us.
Thank
for what you are doing right now, for what you continue to do. Father, we want to thank you for this great promise. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for your love.
Thank you
for demonstrating that love on the cross of Calvary. Father, we are grateful unto you. Thank you for your grace and mercy that is always working for us. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, for helping us even to stand by. Lord God Almighty, Lord, we magnify you.
Amen.
A shade of grace, we put our hand in that this morning and we pray. If there is anything in us that does not glorify your name, Father, let the power in your word, the power in your blood, remove it completely in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Father, please sanctify our hearts.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Holy Spirit of God, we pray this morning. Help us, give us the grace even to trust you the more.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Give us the grace to trust in your failing love.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
That love that is powerful. That love that can deliver.
Yes.
That love that can set free. Father, give us that grace, O Lord, to trust you more in that unfailing
Amen.
Love. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
For the rest of our life, Father, help us to enjoy peace.
Amen.
Help us to enjoy your grace.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus
Amen.
Christ. Father, Lord God Almighty, we pray concerning your word this morning. We pray that you take it over.
Amen.
Lord, you will speak your word.
Amen.
And our life, O Lord, shall be blessed.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus,
Amen.
We commit your son unto you. Father, use him mightily.
Amen.
We pray for fresh air. We pray for fresh anointing.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus,
Amen.
Your word that will come out of his mouth this morning, Father, in heaven, we pray that it shall be back up, O Lord, with signs and wonders,
Amen.
With miracles,
Amen.
With healing. In
Amen.
The mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
As many that we hear your word this morning, our life, O Lord, shall be touched by you.
Amen.
And there shall be a wind of change
Amen.
To the glory of your name.
Amen.
For in Jesus' name we are praying with thanksgiving.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.